sees that interview, maybe he forgot about it, that I assume Donald will apologize where he sees that he said exactly that. With regard to John Kerry, I will say John Kerry's foreign policy has been a disaster for decades. That's why I voted against him when he came up. And the fact that Donald Trump would write him a check and support him against George W. Bush shows exceptionally poor foreign policy judgment. And I'll give one more example in Israel. When the Obama administration canceled civilian air flights into the nation of Israel when Hamas was raining rockets down on them, I publicly asked, is this an economic boycott against Israel? The next day, Michael Bloomberg, another New York billionaire, got on a plane, a commercial flight, and flew to Israel from London. Together, the heat and light that was put on the State Department was so great that within 36 hours, they lifted the ban on air flights into Israel during that entire battle. And indeed, during every battle on Israel, the natural question is, where was Donald? If this is something he cares about, why has he supported anti-Israel politicians from Jimmy Carter to Hillary Clinton to John Kerry for four decades? If you care about Israel, you don't write checks to politicians who are undermining Israel. Instead, you stand and support the national security of America and the alliance.
There's a critical point that needs to be made here.
Governor, he attacked Mr. Trump. Mr. Trump has a right to respond.
Well, look, my response is very simple. There is nobody on this stage that has done more for Israel than I have. Nobody. You might say, you might talk, your politicians all talk, no action. I've been watching it all my life. There is, you are all talk and no action. What I've seen up here, I mean, first of all, this guy's a choke artist and this guy's a liar. You have a combination.
This guy always goes for,
you have a combination of factors. He can't do it for the obvious reason, and he can't do it because he doesn't know how to tell the truth. Other than that, I rest my case.
This is the typical thing he does on any debate about policy. One at a time.